So we're working on polar coordinates. In the first video, I derived the gradient operator, the del operator. And then in the last video, I looked to see how you can take the divergence and the curl of a vector field. In this video, then, I want to look at the Laplacian operator. Okay? So the Laplacian operator is just is what we write as a del squared, which is essentially the dot product of the gradient with itself. So we're going to do this without a function that it's operating on. We're just going to work the differential operator by itself. This would be r hat d dr plus theta hat 1 over r d d theta, and that's dotted against itself, so r hat d dr plus theta hat 1 over r d d theta, and that will give us this del squared operator. Okay, so again, we have four terms. Let's start with the r hat term. So the r derivative doesn't affect r hat and theta hat. They only depend on theta. So the first term here will be r hat dot r hat is 1. So that will simply be the second derivative with respect to r. Okay. The next term is going to be r hat dotted theta hat, which is 0. So the second term here will be a 0. And then we go to the d d theta term, the theta hat term. Now the we have to worry about that the unit vectors depend on theta. The first term here, we have a theta hat dot r hat would be 0. But now r hat depends on theta, and in fact dr hat d theta is equal to theta hat. So when this derivative acts on r hat, we get theta hat, and what we have left over then is a 1 over r d dr. Okay? Because then we have a theta hat dot theta hat, which is 1. Finally, on this last term here, again, theta hat depends on theta, but d theta gives us a minus r hat, which is perpendicular to theta hat, so that term is 0. So this derivative then just works on the derivative term. Theta hat dot theta hat is 1, so we end up with plus 1 over r squared, 1 over r times 1 over r, times the second derivative with respect to theta. Okay? So three terms. This term, d squared dr squared plus 1 over r d dr, that reduces to one term if we write it as 1 over r d dr r d dr, right? The derivative of the first times the second gives us 1 over r 1 over r d dr plus the first times the derivative of the second. The r cancels the r, and we get the second derivative here. And then the last term here is 1 over r squared d theta squared. That's the differential operator that's called the Laplacian. Okay, how does the Laplacian actually work? So if we were going to take the Laplacian of something, we could take the Laplacian of a scalar field, right? Laplacian of a scalar field. That's fine. We can just apply this directly. Or we can take the Laplacian of a vector field. The Laplacian of the vector field is equal to the Laplacian of this u r r hat plus u theta theta hat. And then we have to take the Laplacian of this first term and the Laplacian of this second term. The difficulty here is that these unit vectors then depend on theta. So when you differentiate with respect to theta, you have to take that into account. So this can turn out to be a very complicated expression. So let me summarize. In this series of three lectures, then, I've been working with polar coordinates. We define what polar coordinates is. Many of you do that in a high school course. But what we've done now in these lectures is talk about the gradient operator, and then we did the divergence and the curl, and finally we talked about the Laplacian operator. The Laplacian is very important. It shows up in fluid mechanics, it shows up in electricity and magnetism, and it shows up in quantum mechanics. I'm Jeff Chasnov. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.